Coming back. Let's get my champ status back. I don't give a fuck when I'm married. You get out my dick. I don't give a fuck. Hey. That nigga out of there. I wasn't playing with him. He ain't coming prepared and focused like I was. I'm going for that belt. I want that second belt.
Just remember that very first video I did a long, I think it was like 2 years ago or something like that, about the first lightsaber fighting style. And I meant to do all seven, but you know, I got lazy. I can't really say anything else. So today we're gonna go over something that I think is a gem. It's even more interesting than me just, you know, kind of summarizing the points of each lightsaber fighting style. It comes from Jedi Master Syndrelic. It comes from his notes and his journal from the book Jedi vs. Sith. It's very interesting. It goes over every single fighting style. And if you didn't know, Syndrelic was actually the Jedi Master who taught all the Padawans, all the students, how to fight with a lightsaber. So he was the guy. You know, he was master of all, basically. So before we begin, I just want to say, sit tight and enjoy this video. Lean back, relax, and have fun. The great Omega Holocron has yielded a most enlightening recording by the Jedi Knight Syndrellic, who served as a lightsaber instructor at the Jedi Temple on Coruscant during the final years of the Old Republic. In his recordings, made in 3101, which also means 31 years before Episode 4, Drellic discusses the seven forms, seven fighting disciplines that were studied by the Jedi of his era. Greetings, Padawans. I am Syndrellic, your instructor in lightsaber discipline. I have no doubt that you will all believe you know something of the seven forms of lightsaber combat. All of you spent your first year studying Form 1, and most of you have spent a year or two studying each additional form of Form 1. Some of you will be undecided about whether to now dedicate yourself to one particular form, and some of you may choose to build your own lightsaber fighting style. Whether you have gained additional knowledge on lightsaber combat from data books, seen, or participated in demonstrations, or discovered and experimented with certain techniques on your own, I assure you that you have much to learn about the seven forms. As you know, each form represents differing styles and philosophies, and each has its respective merits. For those of us who are unaware of the unique and subtle differences of the forms, allow me to provide brief descriptions. Form 1, also called Shi Cho, requires little explanation, as every Jedi usually learns the basics of attack, parry, body target zones, and the practice drills called velocities. Form 1 was created by an ancient Jedi during the transition from metal swords to energy beam lightsabers, and the principles of blade contact remained essentially the same. Because the ancient Jedi did not have lightsaber-wielding enemies, Form 1 does not address the lightsaber-to-lightsaber combat. Form 2, also called Makishi, represents the ultimate refinement of lightsaber-to-lightsaber combat. It evolved during an era when battles between Jedi and Dark Jedi had become expected, if not routine, and may have produced the greatest dueling masters the galaxy had ever seen. Masters of Form 2 developed unique offenses and defenses, and trained studiously against having their weapons taken or damaged. Following the Battle of Rusan, Form 2 became an archaism, for there were few situations in which Jedi fought lightsaber-wielding enemies. However, the former Jedi learner, Mora Singh, resurfaced more than a decade ago as a bounty hunter and assassin, and has developed a reputation for taking lightsabers as trophies from her Jedi victims. Furthermore, it is now nearly a year since Obi-Wan Kenobi slew the Sith Lord who killed Qui-Gon Jinn at the Battle of Naboo, and some Jedi Masters have suggested that the Order should re-examine the requirements of Form 2. Other Masters have countered that such confrontations will remain exceedingly rare, so long as the Jedi remain mindful of Force and the Sith limit their numbers to two. As long as Aura Sing and any Sith Lords remain at large, it is the opinion of this instructor that the study of Form 2 should not be dismissed as impractical. Now I'm going to sidestep here and say that Count Dooku used Form 2 very, very well. Form 3, also called Sorsu, was first developed in response to the advancement of blaster technology in the galaxy, as an ever-increasing variety of blaster weapons became available to military factions as well as criminals. Jedi had to revise their lightsaber skills to defend themselves. Originally, the basic principle of Form 3 was laser blast deflection training. This form maximizes defensive protection in a style characterized by tight, efficient movements that expose minimal target areas when compared with the relatively open style of some other forms. Over many centuries, Form 3 has evolved into a highly refined expression of non-aggressive Jedi philosophy. True masters of Form 3 have long been considered invincible, although not always able to overcome their adversaries. No Form 3 masters have ever been defeated. It should be noted that Obi-Wan Kenobi was the master of Sorsu. Form 4, also called Ataru, is the most acrobatic form. Filled with numerous elaborate moves and relies heavily upon a Jedi's ability to run, jump, and spin using the Force. Form 4 can be astonishing to watch. By incorporating all the Force powers that enable one to exceed standard norms of physical possibilities, Jedi may resemble nothing less than a blur when they utilize Form 4. Yes, it is true that Yoda is a Form 4 master. Although it has been many years since Yoda has graced us with a demonstration, the Jedi Archives holds a collection of data books that are testament to his mastery and prowess. Form 5, which has two distinct variations, Xian and Diemso. These were developed alongside Form 4, during an era when Jedi were called upon to more actively maintain the peace in the galaxy, and when purely defensive combat skills, such as those of Form 3, were deemed insufficient. Form 5 focuses on strength and lightsaber attack moves. Form 5's Xian variation exploits the ability of the lightsaber to block the blaster bolt, and turns this defensive move into an offensive attack by deflecting the bolt deliberately. XM Peace through superior firepower. While proponents of 45 regard it as a worthwhile discipline to prepare a Jedi for any threat, there are others who maintain that Form 5 fosters an inappropriate focus on dominating others. You ask my opinion on Form 5? I am neither a proponent nor a detractor. One must question any discipline that has lethal potential. However, if it serves to suppress violent opposition and preserve peace, I believe it is a discipline worth knowing. Form 6, also called Evil. This is the current standard in lightsaber training. This form balances the emphasis of other forms with overall moderation. Through Form 6, a Jedi may achieve true harmony and justice without resorting to the rule of power. It is often referred to as the diplomat's form because it is less intensive in its demands than the other disciplines, allowing Jedi to spend more time developing their skills in perception, political strategy, and negotiation. The Jedi Council maintains that Form 6 best suits the role of contemporary Jedi Knights. After all, a Jedi Knight who is overly trained in martial combat might be at a loss to resolve a complex political conflict or sensitive traits. How long can you expect to study Form 6 before you master it? If you dedicate yourself only to Form 6, you will study for at least 10 years. Is Form 6 the most worthy of study? No. But in general, it is the most practical. I would be negligent if I referred from noting that full masters of other forms have come to consider Form 6 as sufficiently demanding. Form 7, also called Juyo, is the most difficult and demanding of all forms. Only high-level masters of multiple forms can achieve and control this discipline, which can lead to fantastic power and skill. Form 7 employs bold, direct movements, more open and kinetic than Form 5, but not so elaborate in appearance as the acrobatic Form 4. Unlike Form 5, Form 7 requires greater energy because the focus is wielded more broadly and draws upon a deeper well of emotion. While the outward bearing of a Form 7 practitioner is one of calm, the inner pressure verges on explosion. And unlike the graceful, linked movements and sequences of Form 4, Form 7 tactics overwhelm opponents with seemingly unconnected staccato sequences. This combination of traits makes Form 7 highly unpredictable in battle. Because so few have achieved the necessary mastery to advance to Form 7, this discipline can only be regarded as underdevelopment by a select few, and forbidden to all others. Mace Windu and his former Padawan Deku Balaba are among the only current practitioners of Form 7, and even they acknowledge that it is a dangerous regimen that may cut close to the Sith intensity of focus on physical combat ability. And now, let us meditate before we begin basic exercises for Form 6. Now, the 7th lightsaber fighting style, as I've just explained, or actually, as Sith Balaban just explained, is one of the most dangerous and most difficult. However, there was a variation that was created by Mace Windu called Vipod. Now, the video about Vipod is going to be something entirely separate than this one, because it is a variation of Form 7, and it is very long, and it will go into great detail about the creature that is actually called Vipod, and why it was attached to Mace's variant of Form 7 fighting style, and how Mace actually used it to overpower Sidious in the duel in Revenge of the Sith. Now, before I end this video, I'm going to take a piece from the Vipod video that Mace Windu talks about in his data files. As a lightsaber instructor at the temple, Sora trained and influenced